Hump Yards, using gravity to switch rail cars. BNSF Railway's Northtown Yard, located in Minneapolis, Minnesota, is an example of what's called a hump yard. Hump yards get their name for having an artificial mound, crest, or hump in the middle of the yard where cars are pushed over and use gravity to automatically get sorted into a predetermined track. In order to get trains over the hump and this rather steep and short grade, 2 to 3 locomotives are typically put together in order to make this happen, usually with a slug in the center. A slug, in railroad terms, typically consists of a locomotive that has been cut down to about half the height of the long hood, no longer has an engine in it, and receives the power supply for its traction motors from either the front or rear engine in the consist. As the cars are slowly pushed up the hump, a railroad worker pulls the pin on the cars to uncouple them. As the cars are then pushed over the hump, gravity takes over and starts to pull them down, and they're automatically sorted from the hump tower. The hump tower, as seen here on the left, oversees all of the switching operations pertaining to the hump and the yard. They're able to see which cars are coming over, where they're going to go, and determine what tracks the cars are going to be placed in. You've probably noticed by now a loud screeching sound throughout the course of this video. That sound is what's called a retarder. Retarders are used to slow the cars down as they drift down the hump. This is done to prevent cars from smashing into other cars in the bowl tracks and to ensure safe switching operations. Immediately after the car starts to roll down the hump, they hit the primary or main retarder as seen here in the main part of the frame. As they drift further, they hit secondary retarders further down the tracks. The retarders have large pieces of metal flanking their sides to help dampen the sounds of the rail cars as they go past. Retarders work by applying pressure to the sides of the wheels as the rail cars go by. In turn, by applying this pressure, it makes a squealing sound. As we work our way back towards the hump, we can see how the tracks slowly come together. We pass over the secondary set of retarders, and we approach the primary switch that the cars first hit after going over the hump and first primary retarder. Even though the cars are automatically sorted as they go over the hump, from time to time, cars do have to be pulled from one of the groupings and manually set out or taken over to another track. This is called a trim job and what we're seeing here. In this overhead view, we'll see a hopper hitting one of the secondary retarders and slowing down. Think of the force and power it takes to slow a moving rail car as it goes down grade. This method of switching rail cars using gravity enables the railroad to switch hundreds, if not thousands, of rail cars per yard, per day, 24/7. These type of rail yards also tend to be absolutely enormous in their size, scale, and efficiency in switching out rail cars. So, how do the rail cars get to the hump itself? Well, after a train is dropped off and yarded in the receiving yard, a hump set, as seen here on the left, makes its way over to said receiving yard. After getting on to the other end of the cars in the receiving yard, they tie on and start shoving towards the hump at about 3 to 5 miles an hour. Upon reaching the hump, the entire process starts over again. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, subscribe, and comment below what you'd like to see in another video.